upon a time, there were three elephants. There was one, two, three. One, two, three elephants. And they were tall. They liked doing the elephant dance. They liked to flap their elephant ears. They liked to blow their elephant trunks and make a sneezy sound. They were world-class elephants, boys and girls. The best kind of elephant. And they loved just about everything in this big, wide world except mice. Mice gave them the creeps. And they talked among themselves and decided when they build houses, they're going to make sure to make it out of something a mouse could never chew its way into. So the first little elephant found some wonderful material to build a house to keep away any old mouse. Decided to get some toilet paper and some computer paper, some construction paper, some paper cups, some paper plates, paper napkins, and put them all together and make a mouse-proof house. Do you think it's going to work?
No.
Well, we shall see. Because just when he finished kissing his house and going inside, along came the
big bad mouse.
Nice and loud.
Little mice.
No, wait, you're a mouse. That's an elephant.
Little elephant, let me come in. Not by the hair of my nice little trunk.
They nibbled.
Don't die.
They nibbled so much that the house started breaking apart and there was nothing left of that house and the poor elephant. The second little elephant. Wearing beautiful pink smock that day, decided to make a mouse-proof house, not of toilet paper and paper plates. That stuff's no good. She was too clever for that. Why, she used some good, strong cardboard. And she kept on building that house that would keep away any nasty mouse. And she finally finishes cardboard house. Just as she was about to go inside, along came that first elephant who said,
"Quick! The mice are coming! Come inside!"
Then along came
the big bad mice!
little elephants, let me come in. Not by the hair of our little nice trunks. Then I'll chew, and I'll nibble through your house.
They nibbled. Just listen to that nibbling. It was a nibbling frenzy. And when they finished, there was nothing left of that cardboard. Well, let's meet that third little elephant. Let's see if things go better. Are you going to use toilet paper rolls and napkins, little elephant?
No.
You going to use fridge box made out of cardboard?
No.
So what are you going to use?
Titanium alloy.
Titanium alloy? Why, I hardly even know what that is. Let's take a look. Here comes the elephant's house made of expensive durable, and everlasting titanium alloy. Oh, look at that. It looks heavy duty. Well, along came those other elephants who said,
"Quick! The big bad wolves are coming! Quick, come inside!"
They were well hidden inside that house. You'd never know they were in there. But along came
the little bad mice.
They tried, they chewed, and they nibbled and they gnawed, but something was not working. The elephant started to giggle. I told them to try again.
Try again!
They nibbled, they gnawed, they chewed, but still nothing. And the elephant said,
try again!
They tried again, and again, and again. But all you could hear was the sound of breaking teeth. Listen. They weren't feeling too well in the end. Out came the elephants. And that clever elephant number 3 ended up with a moral lesson that we can remember the rest of our life. Go ahead, elephant.
And that's why I built my house out of titanium alloy.
What do you say? What's going on? Let's give it a hand.